Om Namah Shivaya students, today we are going to start with class 11 history, section 4 towards modernization, theme 11, part 3, path to modernization. In this session, we will have a discussion about the one, modernizing the Japanese economy, industrial workers, aggressive nationalism, Fukuzawa Yukichiki, 1835 to 1901. This will be followed with the assignment to be completed in theme 11 part 3. Students, we have already learned in the previous session that the Meiji power succeeded over the Shogun in Japan. Now under the Meijis, many reforms have taken place. Another reform that we are talking about in this part of the session is about the Meiji reform, about the modernizing of the economy of Japan. Funds were raised by levying an agricultural tax. Japan's first railway line between Tokyo and the port of Yokohama was built in 1870 and 72. Now these are important to note for your objective type question. Now textile machinery was imported from Europe and foreign technicians were employed to train workers as well as to teach in the universities and schools, and Japanese students were sent abroad. In 1872, modern banking institutions were launched in Japan. Companies like Mitsubishi, Sumitomo were helped through subsidies and tax benefits to become major shipbuilders, so that Japanese trade was from now on carried in Japanese ships. Zaibatsu, large business organization controlled by the individual families, dominated the economy till after the Second World War. The population of Japan, 35 million in 1872, increased to 55 million in 1920. To reduce population pressure, the government actively encouraged migration, first to the northern islands of Hokkaido, which had been a largely autonomous area where the indigenous people called the Ainu lived, and then to Hawaii and Brazil, as well as to growing colonial empire of the Japan. Within Japan, there was a shift to towns as industries developed in Japan. By the 1925, 21% of the population lived in cities. By 1935, this figure had gone up to 32% in Japan. About the industrial workers, the number of people in manufacturing increased from 7 lakh in 1870 to 4 million in 1913. Most of them worked in units employing less than 5 people and using neither machinery nor electric power. Over half those employed in the modern factories were women, and it was women who organized their first modern strike in 1886. After 1900, the number of men began to increase, but only in 1930s did male workers begin to outnumber the women. The size of the factories also began to increase. Factories employing more than 100 workers, just over 1,000 in 1909, jumped to over 2,000 by 1920 and 4,000 by the 1930s. Yet even in the 1940s, there were over 5,50,000 workshops that employed less than 5 employees. Now this sustained the family-centered ideology in Japan. Just as nationalism was sustained by a strong patriarchal system, that is male-dominated system, under an emperor who was like a family patriarch, the rapid and unregulated growth of the industry and the demand for natural resources such as timber led to the environmental destruction in Japan. Tanaka Sozo, elected to first House of the Representatives, launched the first agitation against the industrial pollution in 1897, with 800 villagers in mass protest, forcing the government to take action against this problem. Aggressive nationalism. The Meiji Constitution was based on the restricted franchise and created a Diet. The Japanese used the German word for parliament because of the influence of the German legal ideas with limited powers. The leaders who brought about the imperial restoration continued to exercise power and even established political parties. Now, between 1918 to 1931, popularly elected prime ministers formed cabinets. Thereafter, they lost power in national unity cabinets formed across party lines. The emperor was the commander of the forces from 1890. This was interpreted to mean that the army and the navy had independent control in 1899. The prime minister ordered that only serving generals and admirals could become ministers. Now, this strengthening of the military, together with the expansion of Japan's colonial empire, was connected with the fear that Japan was at the mercy of the Western powers. This fear was used to silence opposition to military expansion and to higher taxes to fund the armed forces in Japan. You can see over here the figure which shows about the growth of army and the growth of the young people being exhorted to fight for the nation. A magazine cover, student soldier photographs you can see over here. This talks about the building of army under the Meiji. Fukuzawa Yukishi, 1835-1901, born in an impoverished samurai family. He studied in Nagasaki and Osaka, learning Dutch and Western sciences and later English. In 1860, he went as a translator for the first Japanese embassy, the USA. This provided material for a book on the West, written not only in classical but in the spoken style that became extremely popular. He established a school that is today the Keio University. He was one of the core members of the Merikosoa, a society to promote Western learning. In the encouragement to learning, Gakumon no Susume, 1872-76, he was very critical of Japanese knowledge. All that Japan has to be proud of is its scenery. He advocated not just modern factories and institutions, but the cultural essence of the West, the spirit of civilization. With this spirit, it would be possible to build a new citizen. His principle was, heaven did not create men above men, nor set men below men. This is the people, those who have started with the restoration of power to. In the next generation question, this total acceptance of the Western ideas and urged that national pride be built on indigenous value. The philosopher Miyake Sesure, 1860-1945, argued that each nation must develop its special talents in the interest of the world civilization. To devote oneself to one's country is to devote oneself to the world. By contrast, many intellectuals were attracted to Western liberalism and wanted Japan based not on military but on democracy. Yuki Emori, a leader of the popular rights movement, was demanding constitutional government, admired the French Revolution's doctrine of the natural rights of the man and of the popular sovereignty, and spoke for a liberal education that would develop each individual freedom. Freedom is more precious than order. Others even advocated voting rights for women. This pressure led the government to announce a constitution in Japan. Assignment that has to be done in Chapter 11, Part 3 are as follows. Number 1. How did the modernization of economy started in Japan? Number 2. What were the major developments before Meiji Restoration that made it possible for the Japan to modernize rapidly? These two questions, you go through the text properly and understand it. Listen to the classes and then write down the answer of this. In the next session, section 5 towards modernization, theme 11, part 4, path to modernization, we will continue with. Om Namah Shivaya.